of peers and entrepreneurs themselves, which perhaps many investors outside this door wouldn't want to take that risk. But I think that at the end, the organizations that get chosen and what we've found in the past, that these are the ones that really excel. So thank you. The social businesses group is one big group, if you can all put your hands up. Das Kahania, although there's more than 10 people in it. It's okay. So this group of social businesses also worked in the same format, in the peer funding format, and scored each other with the investment criteria that they came up with. And the $75,000 that each of these two winners get as a first infusion of equity is coming from First Light. And I'd like to invite both John and Ross, if you can come up and give the award. They've come all the way from Atlanta, so it would be a shame to not have you say a few words. So please, before I announce.
Well, I think we saw on Tuesday how far all of you have come. You know, when we first saw, you know, synopsis of your companies, and then hearing from Bob, you know, the pitches here, you guys have all done an incredible job, which is readily apparent. So thank you all for participating. It's clear that whoever wins will be getting, we will be getting a great entrepreneur and a great company to work with. So we're excited for whatever the result. And thank you very much to the Dozer team for all that you do. And again, a round of applause to you guys. And the Kleisners for working with us on this.
I just want to add one thing to the investors in the room. You might think it's absolutely crazy that we're letting entrepreneurs make investment decisions, but I think what we find is entrepreneurs at this stage, all of them have a million benefits and all of them have a million challenges. And where we're coming from is let the entrepreneurs decide who is the most ready for investment, and then we as investors will take what we'll get and work with the entrepreneurs to try and make it a great business. I think that there are so many more promising entrepreneurs than get funded out there. So I encourage other investors to maybe come in with us on these enterprises or fund others and come along.
So I'll announce each one separately. The first winner is perhaps, sure. Can we guess? Milab.
I think the process was a little bit biased because I was treated like a kid. You know, I was the youngest guy in the entire cohort. So peers, the beer is on me tonight. But honestly, I mean, we were confused initially as a social enterprise, you know, following a hybrid model, you know, trying to understand and, you know, where exactly we fit in, you know, because hybrid is such a confusing state. It's exotic, but it's also confusing. And I actually took the decision after talking to my peers, you know, and some of my peers actually advised me saying that you are better off, you know, sitting in the social business category as opposed to nonprofits. And I think, I mean, when they made that decision at that point of time, they already thought that, you know, I was an investment ready company. Thanks a lot, means a lot to us. We have been bootstrapping all along for the past 12 months, trying to prove something that people have called us crazy. People have said that if you screw this up, you will be behind bars because of a lot of legal regulatory issues. But my peers have believed in me, and yeah, so yeah, we'll meet outside tonight.
our next winner of the Village Capital is a little bit of a story that I feel compelled to share with you. I don't think we have anyone who's been through three cohorts. You know, you would think that's not possible. So we first worked with this organization when this great idea was sitting under a slow, bureaucratic, old-style nonprofit. And that was cohort three when we worked with this individual. And then we had the privilege of having First Light and come and say, let's start this Village Capital. And we went back to our alumni class and invited them to come to Village Capital. This organization actually won the Village Capital from cohort four, but decided actually that he didn't have the support of the nonprofit to do the social business that he had come up with and the idea, and then eventually plucked up the courage to leave the nonprofit, start his own for-profit, spin it out, and then come back into cohort five. It's Naveen.
Thank you all. I would like to say some of the people who are behind this award and whom I'll be indebted throughout my life. I would like to mention when I left the non-for-profit and I had some serious personal problems and I had only 7,000 rupees left in my pocket. And I was wandering in the streets of Varanasi having chai with rickshawala. Then suddenly, one support came from the person who I met for just 10 minutes in Mumbai. I asked for support from every person I knew, but nothing turned up. And that guy, in one email, he sent me a personal loan of 90,000 rupees. And that was the moment when things started. And that was Bob and then again, I got Lisa is for you. Lisa came in the very incredible time. I would like to thank Tej, who has been incredible, Andy, all my team members. I share this all with you. And I hope that I'll keep up to your expectations in future. Thank you.
Congratulations to everybody who's won the awards. This kind of wraps up. There's never a time where I won't shed a tear. You're all like my little children, so congratulations to all of you. Thank you all for coming and joining us.